Over the next 7 minutes, we will travel through the Earth's atmosphere and eventually reach outer space. The approximate speed we will be traveling is 620 miles per hour, so buckle up and get ready for a ride. We are currently in the troposphere, the lowest layer of the atmosphere. The troposphere contains 99% of the water vapor in the atmosphere. Nimbostratus clouds are responsible for rainy days. As we climb, the temperature continues to drop. Cumulonimbus clouds are tall, towering clouds that can produce lightning, tornadoes, and hail. During World War I, military zeppelins would ascend to altitudes above 4,000 meters to stay out of range of enemy aircraft and ground fire. However, this often led to discomfort for the crew due to the cold temperatures and reduced oxygen levels. Cirrus clouds are wispy clouds made out of ice crystals. Above this altitude is known as the death zone, because there isn't enough oxygen for human life. If you've ever wondered where your lost balloons went, this is where a typical party balloon will pop. Cirrocumulus clouds are patchy clouds that can cover the sky. As the air pressure drops, so does the temperature needed to boil water. At this altitude, water boils at only 129 degrees Fahrenheit. Jet streams are bands of strong winds in the atmosphere. They can reach speeds of up to 275 miles per hour. Welcome to the stratosphere. The stratosphere is home to the ozone layer that protects us from harmful UV rays. Unlike the troposphere, the temperature in the stratosphere increases the higher you go. This is the Armstrong limit. Above this altitude, your saliva and tears will boil if you don't have a pressurized suit. Noctilucent clouds are rare clouds found in polar regions. They are made up of small ice particles that scatter light in colorful ways. As the air gets thinner, there are fewer molecules to scatter the light. So the sky gets darker. The State Route 71 is one of the fastest aircraft ever built. It can fly more than 3 times the speed of sound. With nothing but a duct-taped pressure suit, Joseph Kittinger jumped from an open gondola, setting a record that would stand for more than 50 years. The ash cloud from the eruption that destroyed Pompeii reached this height. Launched from a balloon, this is the highest a paper airplane has flown. Felix Baumgartner was the first person to break the sound barrier in free fall. The mushroom cloud from the Castle Bravo nuclear test reached that height. Space elevators are actually a possible idea being considered by scientists. They could potentially be a cheaper and safer way to get to space. The hard part is making a strong enough cable. Blue jets are a rare form of lightning that arc upward in a brilliant blue flash. Well done. You have reached the mesosphere and are now halfway to space. The air in the mesosphere is very thin. It has less than 1% of the pressure of air at sea level. The fastest elevator in the world travels at 46 miles per hour. A space elevator traveling at the same speed would take 81 minutes to reach space. A typical 10-story building elevator would take 13 hours and 53 minutes to make the same trip. the mushroom cloud from the largest nuclear test ever conducted, Tsar Bomba, reached this altitude. Sprites are a rare form of lightning seen above thunderstorms that last only a fraction of a second. While normal lightning is about 4 kilometers long, sprites can reach lengths of up to 50 kilometers. Since the speed of sound depends on temperature, sound travels
15% slower up here.
Noctilucent clouds are the highest clouds in the atmosphere. They are only visible at night and at higher latitudes. Most meteors burn up in the mesosphere. It's estimated that over 48 tons of meteors enter the atmosphere every day. That's the equivalent of 8 to 10 elephants falling out of the sky every day. This is the coldest part of the Earth's atmosphere. Welcome to the thermosphere, the final layer of our journey into space. At an altitude of 100 kilometers, the Kármán line is generally accepted as the beginning of space. Temperatures in the thermosphere can reach 4,532 degrees Fahrenheit, but the molecules are so far apart that you wouldn't even feel it. When particles from the sun hit the atmosphere, they excite the atoms in the air. These excited atoms begin to glow, creating brilliant displays of light called auroras. You are about to reach a place where fewer than 1,000 people have ever been. You are now leaving the Earth and crossing the Kármán line. Welcome to space.